All right, we're here at Southern Skies construction trailer, and we have Blake Smith, who's our chief science officer. And so just to help Mississippians understand a little bit better, we're trying to explain that cannabis is really medicine. There's really some really, really good medicine. There are a lot of conditions that Mississippi has allowed patients to use cannabis to treat. So we are going to try to talk about those list of conditions specifically, and then what specific cannabis product can help you with those conditions. So we're going to let Blake, we're going to put him to the test and throw questions at him. We're going to try to stump the chump today. So
Blake. I am a chump.
So like I said, Blake is our chief science officer. He's from Utah, but he's going to help us set up our lab here. He's going to be the one that's going to be directing all of our extraction processes. And extraction means we're going to extract the medicine out of the plant and then put it in a different form to deliver it to you. We'll put it in gummies and chocolate bars and tinctures, drops you'll put under your tongue, tablets that you can put under your tongue. There's a number of different avenues to get the medicine from the plant into a person that's needing it for their medical condition. All right, here we go. We're going to talk about sickle cell anemia. You got any input on whether or not cannabis can help with sickle cell?
I have input on everything. Just kidding. Look, sickle. So, okay, can I give props to Mississippi real quick?
Absolutely.
All the conditions we've talked about so far, like, these are real serious conditions. Absolutely. Like, you know, we have struggled in the medical community figuring how to treat a lot of these things. Sickle cell anemia is another one of them that is can be extremely painful, that can have a lot of effects. And really, what you're mostly going to feel with sickle cell is a lot of effects from that. And so pain is one of the big ones associated with that. Okay, so Mississippi, well done. You've picked really hard ones to include in your program, which is really good. Yeah. That's a really good thing, so well done. Sickle cell anemia, typically speaking, so there's a lot of long-term effects, but affecting the GABA pathway is extremely important for that. So CBD is actually one of the most effective. Now, having said that, lowering inflammation is not going to fix the pain associated with sickle cell anemia. A lot of that pain happens because you're having problems with the actual blood moving through all those mini alveoli and all the various things throughout the body. Your blood is moving because your cells are not all smooth and free flowing. And so you get, you know, propensity to have other issues, blockages, and all kinds of stuff that happens. So masking is, again, a place where THC is appropriate for this one. And so, but I would always pair that with CBD in this particular case.